Here we are walking through another question on the certified Q&A for the Google Cloud Platform Associate Cloud Engineer. It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this scenario, your project team has been tasked to create a new Kubernetes cluster on Google Cloud Platform that can autoscale the number of worker nodes. What should you do? Before you discuss with the team, let us understand what are the key requirements. One, we know the project is based on Kubernetes and there is a Kubernetes cluster. And we need to autoscale the number of worker nodes depending on the load we receive. Before we get into a discussion of the options, let's discuss with the team what exactly is Kubernetes and what is the architecture that we will be dealing with. When Kubernetes creates a cluster for you, it creates at least one master node that controls the entire cluster. Then there can be multiple nodes, depicted in blue here, each of which contains individual pods that contain the containers. When you scale the backend, you ideally want to follow the load such that we don't overrun the costs or we don't underserve the requests. So it's necessary to know that we don't over-provision or under-provision. And when we talk about scaling Kubernetes, what do we mean? We mean essentially that we can increase the number of nodes available such that the number of pods that we want to deploy have enough space, have enough resources within which they can be deployed. So the key element that we want to scale here is the node itself. We talked to Bob, and Bob comes up with a suggestion that we enable autoscaling on the instance group of the cluster. This seems a good idea because it means that we can have a solution that potentially scales with the load we receive. Since it is also based on, say, an instance group, it means we will have a bunch of similar instances, which is great when we want to scale a service. Homogeneity in the scaled instances give consistency in how we deal with them and make scaling easier. And what is an instance group? An instance group is a collection of virtual machines. They all manage machines that look exactly the same and they're managed as one single entity. They're great for serving stateless workloads, for batch, high performance, or high throughput compute workloads, such as image processing from a queue. So you can queue up a whole bunch of tasks and have them be worked on by different instances that are automatically created within a managed instance group. It's the same when you have an increase in load of users. You can also automatically scale the number of machines in instance group based on an instance template such that it can serve that load without cutting off any of the requests. So Bob's suggestion that we autoscale the instance group of the cluster seems to tick all the boxes that we will have scaling. We can grow with the amount of requests and all of that, but there is only one problem. Kubernetes engine does not work with instance groups. Compute engine scaling does work with managed instance groups, but not Kubernetes engine. Therefore, we are going to eliminate this option. Now, Charlie comes up with an option and suggests that we configure a compute engine instance as a worker, add it to an unmanaged instance group, then add a load balancer to the instance group and rely on the load balancer to create additional compute engine instances when required. We ask the team, okay, what is an unmanaged instance group? when there is an unmanaged instance group, you have individual heterogeneous machines that each have a different configuration. So you're going to be creating these individual instances and adding it to the unmanaged instance group. If we had to do that, where we are configuring specific compute engine instances, it defeats the basis of autoscaling. Moreover, comparing managed and unmanaged instance groups, you will see that managed instance groups offers autoscaling, autohealing, regional deployment, and automatic updating. This makes it suitable for highly available and scalable services, while none of those benefits are there for the unmanaged instance group. So, even though instance groups have been already laid out, we've got additional info here that says this just is not going to work, and the fact that it's an unmanaged instance group does not make it any better. The third part of the suggestion is that we add a load balancer to the instance group. Although we've pretty much eliminated this option, let's see whether this makes sense at all, just as learning for the future. Load balancers are not added to an instance group. Load balancers have managed instance groups as their backend. So the suggestion of adding a load balancer to an instance group is itself not workable. Given all of that, we can now eliminate option C. Dave now suggests that we create a compute engine instances for the workers and the master, and then we install Kubernetes using those workers and master. Then we just pass on the job to Kubernetes to create additional compute engine instances when needed. Quite a few problems with Dave's suggestion here. One, the master is not controlled or configured by us. The Google Compute Engine service manages the master, and we do not have a way to configure this machine. So creating a Compute Engine instance and passing it to GKE is not possible. Kubernetes also does not work with pre-provisioned Compute Engine instances. Yes, they do work with VMs, but not via Compute Engine. So given given that's the way that Kubernetes engine works, we can eliminate option D because this is not a workable solution. How about Alice's suggestion that we create a cluster on Kubernetes engine and enable autoscaling on Kubernetes engine? It seems straightforward, right? Alice's suggestion is that when you create the cluster itself, you probably tick a box saying enable autoscaling. If this worked, this suggestion would be great, and it would work for us very well. Let us now go check it as a team and ensure that this possibility does exist. Now, what are we scaling? What we want to scale is the number of nodes. The nodes itself contains the pods, which is the unit that Kubernetes controls to serve applications. These nodes themselves come from a node pool. When you create a cluster on GKE, there is a default node pool that is created for you. When you have more machines in the node pool, Kubernetes can scale by picking up those machines from that node pool. Therefore, it seems that the more number of nodes we have, it becomes easier for Kubernetes to scale. How do we do that? When you create the Kubernetes cluster, as in step one, we have chosen a standard cluster. In step two, when we define the node pool, we can say the number of nodes we want in that node pool. And here, we can set a large number so that our Kubernetes cluster never runs out of machines or nodes to pick and use. But then this creates a problem of over-provisioning. Why would you create all these extra instances if they're not being used continuously? we are going to incur a huge cost in just having these machines meant for peak load already provisioned and kept in the node pool. So this is not a preferable solution. Does Google Cloud Kubernetes Engine have another option that allows us to automatically scale? Looking at some of the documentation and the blogs, here is an excerpt. GKE's cluster autoscaler automatically resizes clusters based on the demands of selected workloads. With autoscaling enabled, GKE automatically adds a new node to your cluster if a newly created pod lacks the capacity to run. Conversely, if a node in your cluster is underutilized and its pod can be run on another node, GKE will delete it. So, with autoscaling enabled, GKE will automatically bring up new nodes or take them down depending on the load on the system. Given all of this, this is the right answer, and we choose this as the right option for the question. Let us just confirm that it is possible. Looking at the Google Cloud console and creating a cluster, we've already done step one of starting the cluster creation. Then while creating the node pool, we can go to more options and edit the node pool. In the node pool options, we have a checkbox that allows us to simply enable autoscaling. When you enable autoscaling, you're also asked to choose the minimum number of nodes and the maximum number of nodes so that you have at least some instances that are always warm, so that if fresh load comes in a sudden burst, you are not waiting for that machine to load up. At the same time, you can also cap off the maximum number of nodes so that you don't incur runaway costs for some reason of sudden spikes in load. Great. So what are the key learnings we can take away from this question? One, compute engine scales with managed instance groups. Even unmanaged instance groups is not a good option to scale compute engine. Kubernetes engine, on the other hand, scales using node pools. Google Kubernetes engine has an inbuilt feature to auto-scale the nodes in a pool. You just need to check a checkbox in the edit node pool to have this feature as part of your cluster. From a business and financial standpoint, scaling to meet demand is a business necessity. You can't have customer requests being unserved. At the same time, scaling just enough to stay ahead of demand is a financial necessity. You don't want to over-provision machines and incur a huge cost continuously through your business day. In terms of studying, please learn Kubernetes quite a bit. It is very popular and used in a lot of enterprise workloads today. And you will have to study things like the cluster architecture, how to set up node pools, how to create, how to manage the pods and the containers. You have to also learn tools like kubectl and where kubectl is useful and where you have to use gcloud. For some of those, I will leave it with a bunch of references on the architecture, node pools, autoscaling, instance groups, and on how to manage your costs on Kubernetes. Well, how are you going to inform others of this super GCP content? Just one way, like it, share it, let them get to know of it, and you subscribe.